The amount of assumptions that have been made about me in just 2020 is baffling. I want you to remember, don't assume what you don't know.
J-Man, the Vanderwall fan, back at it again with another video. As always, I want to welcome all of my fellow Vanderwalls, as well as any guests, especially those that might be discovering Grace for the first time. If that is you, welcome aboard. You are very, very welcome to join. more the merrier, actually. We'd love to have you. Come on. So, anyways, that intro. Yeah, that took me a minute to make because maybe this could be something. Is an incredibly beautiful song, and if you don't think so, you might have a problem. Yeah, it was incredibly hard to make that video. I don't know why. She knows how to do it. She knows how to pull the tug at your heartstrings, and you just can't help it, man. Anyways. How about the video of the week? Don't assume what you don't know. God, that's a good song. If you don't like that song, there's definitely something wrong with you also. But I love that song, and I am happy that it's the video of the week. that was a lot of fun to make that video at the very, very beginning. The little preview for the song of the week. I don't know. I enjoy doing this stuff. So, I mean, I'm going to keep it changing, you know. But anyways, go check it out. I misspelled comment. I'm not going to go back and fix it because it's too much work, but I misspelled comment in the video. I apologize. I'm working on my reviewing everything before I post it. It's just it's a lot to do. So I apologize, but yes, don't go comment. Yes, they sound different. They are different. One's got an N, one doesn't. So go do that. Comment, like, and share. That all said, welcome to You're So Beautiful again. Now, I know we just ended that yesterday, but here we are. We're going to listen to some You're So Beautiful because you're so beautiful, and the song is so beautiful, and Grace is so beautiful, and we're all so beautiful. And so, this is a request via Paul D. Hoff, and it's a cell phone recording, I think. And if it is, that's okay. We're okay with that. Why are we okay with that? Because it is... going to be a good one, I have no doubt, because okay, sorry, Is this a bold? Is this? I wonder if this is his. This might be his recording. And if it is, I know it's going to be good because his turned out really, really good. So, what do you say we just jump on into it and forget this mess of talking? You know, no one wants that. Everyone wants Grace VanderWaal. I want Grace VanderWaal. Okay, whoa. Let's back that up just a little bit before we say something that could be misinterpreted. I want to listen to Grace VanderWaal. Let's just be adults about what I almost said, because that's not what I meant. Yeah. And of course, I forgot to do one of the most important aspects of this entire process, and that is to get the video ready. So, just gonna chit the chat a little bit for a minute. I think we got it. All right. Well, forget the talk. We're just gonna go right back into the zone.
You were saying, watch me, fucking let me survive.
Paul, I must say, if there's one thing this guy did that was right, absolutely right about recording a show, was he was in that sweet spot. You can tell because he's center and he's back far enough from the monitors that he is literally picking up the sound quality better than if you're right up against people. Anybody that's right up near the stage, you're either going to miss pieces or you're just going to get clipped. Being in all that he looked like he was right in the spot. If I'm not mistaken, he recorded these, if I'm right. But whoever recorded it, regardless, they were in the sweet spot. The sweet spot is where all the sound comes in, but it's balanced. By that point, it's balanced because it comes out of the speakers really loud, and then it's balanced by the time it reaches about the middle or the back, depending upon the size of the venue. And I know this from experience. And the sweet spot has been found for this particular concert. And, it's not perfect. It's not absolutely perfect. Her vocals are not crystally pristine, but it doesn't matter. I can still hear them, and I know what she's doing, and she sounds beautiful, and she sounds amazing. And I still love this song. I mean, I know that hadn't changed in 1 week, but, I mean, I have loved You're So Beautiful from the very second that the first time I heard it, when the music started, I was in love with that song that moment. Like, it just took the music starting for me to love that song. But then the rest of it just all fell into place with her vocals and her lyrics. And I think it's a fantastically beautiful song. And I really want to see her live. I'm hoping to get to see her live so soon. I mean, I hope there's a tour coming because, gosh, she just seems like she's a ball of energy when she's out there. And I've heard that she pretty much is, and that the energy in her shows is really good and really powerful. And her presence is really good, and she knows how to hold the crowd in the palm of her hands. The girl is just a natural at writing, singing, performing. And I've said this so many times, and I want to say it again because it's very important to me that I guess that everybody knows this, that I would take Grace VanderWaal alone on a stage, of course with her band, but alone on a stage, dancing the way she does over a large dance number of the best dancers on the planet any day of the week. Because there's something real, you know, when it's choreographed and thought out and everything, it's like, it's the same dance move that's been formed 1,000 times prior. And it's just so like mechanical and so it's just so formal. I guess you could say formal would be right. No, that wouldn't be the correct word. It just bores me a little bit. I don't know. I can't explain it. It's just, I don't care for large dance numbers, but her doing what she does on the stage it's real. It's pure. It's natural. It's her. It's not, she doesn't think about it until she does it. As Michael once said, you dance within the music. She dances within the music. She just doesn't do dance moves like your typical dancer would. She just feels it and does what she feels. And that, to me, is more real than any choreographed large dance number that you could ever throw my direction, even with the great Michael Jackson himself. It doesn't matter who it is. It's just, it's real. When it's Grace doing what she does, it's real to me. And it means something more to me that way. And this girl has literally made me change so much of who I am when it comes to watching music and listening to music, because I literally wouldn't, I didn't care for live shows. I didn't do it. I'd rather watch a music video. And with Grace, I'd rather watch her live. I don't care for cell phone recordings. I never have, because they always usually suck. But it doesn't matter, because I want to listen to Grace VanderWaal no matter what she's, as long as I can hear her voice, we're golden. This girl just doesn't stop changing who I am. I would like a little say-so in what I like and don't like, but she won't let me have it because she's so incredibly good that it don't matter what she's doing, whether it be a music video, a live performance, a cell phone recording, whether it be the voice cracks, the vibrato, the raspy voice or the whatever. It doesn't matter what she does. She can do any of the things. Literally, I have yet to find one thing about her performances or her recordings or anything that I don't find to be absolutely wonderful and interesting and worth the listen. And this is no different. This is just another one of those, I don't like cell phone recordings, but I loved every second of this. And Nolan Frank, man, you dog, you know, Nolan. I gotta give him some props, man. That guy, he's always into it, man. I always see him being into the music. Like, you can watch the You're So Beautiful at the YouTube, I think it was a YouTube concert where he did Vienna, where she did Vienna and Waste My Time. He's all, what's up, you know? He's just so full of energy and he's so full of life. And I love that he was part of her band. I hope he continues to be part of her band in the future, but who knows? He could be playing with someone else by now. Then you have Ben and Melissa, who are also fantastic musicians. I love Melissa. I think she's a fantastic guitarist. And I think it's wonderful that she's worked so closely with Grace for so long. And I hope she comes back to Grace. And Ben's my dude, man. As a drummer, Ben's my dude. I absolutely love the guy. He's such a phenomenal drummer. He stuck with her through the years, and I've seen him on some of her Instagram lives popping up, and you know, he just seems like they all seem like they genuinely care. Well, at least Melissa and Ben both seem like they genuinely care for Grace. I don't know about Nolan, but based on how he acts at her shows, I would say that he does. He's trying to get the band hyped up, not for himself. He's doing it for her, and that to me is admirable. And let me just say, she's got a good support group right there behind her on stage, and I think it's phenomenal, and they deserve every bit of credit that they get because they're wonderful, and Grace is Grace can be good without them, but she's better with them. And I say that, and it means that they provide her with the backing that she needs to be able to be good on stage. I think a live band's always better. Backing tracks are good. But live band, you get a more real feel with that. And she's got a good one behind her, and it makes her sound good. She makes them sound good. It's a great relationship. And you know what? We get stuff like this. So I hope you guys enjoyed this. I sure did. Paul, thank you so much for that. And if you got I would like to see some more. What other songs you have, request them, and we'll do them, because I your videos are good. Your videos are some of the cell phone recordings I like. So keep them coming. I hope you guys enjoyed. Catch you on the next video, and go check out the video of the week. Don't assume what you don't know. Go check it out. Thanks a lot for watching. We'll